Okay, this next family is pretty cool. Aphrodoridae. Did I pronounce that right? I think so. Only one species. They're actually fairly common. We get these all the time. These are the pirate perch. They're not at all related to other perch. This family's been around a while, but only that one species is still living. These are a close relative of the cavefish, which is the next family we're going to talk about. So they have a lot of similarities with cavefish. The pirate perch, their name means throat excrement, which is a nice way of saying shithead. Well, why are they called that? Because their anus and their urogenital opening is up near their throat. And so that's pretty much an easy way to identify these fish. Now, it doesn't start out that way. It starts out in what you would consider a typical position, but then it migrates as the fish grows. That opening moves up toward the throat. And so they kind of have a fairly typical sunfish shape. When you catch these in the wild, they usually have a pretty unique purple coloring. And so that kind of catches your eye. And then when you look and you see that anus up underneath the throat, then you know you've got a pirate perch. And so, well, the question is why does this happen? Why do they have their anus here? And the early, one of the hypotheses is that they are mouth brooders, or they brood in the gill chamber, which would be kind of the same thing. Because they're close relatives of cavefish, and cavefish do this. And also, if you look anterior to that anus, you see kind of a little knob there. And eggs that flow out of this urogenital opening, kind of, there's some grooves there that kind of move along that knob and move the eggs into the mouth. And so it seems logical that that's why this is here, is because it just enhances the mouth brooding, and in their close relative, they mouth brood. But it's probably not true. And some people I used to go to school with published a paper, and they actually observed the pirate perch spawning in a tank. And what they observed was that, yes, the eggs do move into the mouth, but then they get spit out into the substrate. And this kind of pulls together a few other research projects, because other people said that, you know, they've seen them building nests, and why would you build a nest if you're a mouth brooder? But this is probably why. You build the nest, and then the eggs go into your mouth and you spit them out. So probably, you know, common ancestor of cavefish and the pirate perch, you know, was a mouth brooder. So they have this in their DNA, but the pirate perch have modified it for a different kind of parental care. So it's pretty interesting. But that's all I know about pirate perch. So thanks. See ya.